Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's your girl, Coco Styles. And on this channel, we talk about beauty, fashion, and lifestyle. I also run a blog called Coco Styles NYC, where I talk about styles and how to style certain things like jackets and skirts and things for us tall ladies, or just style in general. But in today's video, I was just sitting here in my YouTube room, which is also like a second part of my closet. And I wanted to talk to you ladies about the importance of, well, I don't want to say importance. I want to say goal setting for your wardrobe. And I just want to jump right into it. And number one, I would say the most important thing about setting goals for your wardrobe is knowing what your aesthetic is going to be. If you are a person who loves boho, chic, your closet should actually scream that looking into it. Your closet should not look edgy if you like boho chic. So I would say, for me as an example, I am in between classy, classic, classy, and edgy chic. But then I dabble in a little bit of, I don't even want to say whimsical because that's very, very girly. But on occasion I would wear something like that, but the majority you would see me in leather, you would see me in shawls, you would see me in nudes and tans, browns and camel colors. I do sometimes sprinkle in a little bit of other colors, and that's things that go with my skin. But that's the first thing, building your wardrobe and having wardrobe goals, starting with your aesthetics and knowing what you're actually trying to achieve, well, color-wise. Number two, I would say, is what are you trying to achieve? What type of brands do you like? What brands do not sell or carry your new aesthetic style? So I would say, again, I'm gonna use myself as an example, All Saints. All Saints have beautiful leather jackets that I love, and they so happen to actually fit us tall women. Also, Kenneth Cole. So when I'm goal setting for my closet, in certain pieces, like investment pieces, I do not budge when it comes to purchasing those items. If I was not a person who really loved leather, then I would go for something that is a faux leather. Now, nowadays it's very hard to find full leather that is not out of this world with the price, but you still can. So that's number two. Find a brand and stuff that actually carries the things that actually fit your aesthetic. All right, so number three, what I would say in goal setting, is organize your closet. Organizing your closet will definitely make you feel like you're in a department store. So if you're waking up and your stuff is all over the place, that's not gonna make you excited to wanna go into your closet. Now, if you guys look behind me, I do have a rack in here. Then I have another rack over there and just some shelves and stuff that I wanted to just bring into this room. I may pan over, I don't know. But I do have like two mirrors in here. And I have like a small little bistro table in the corner. So this is like my little department store. I need an ottoman in here. Long story, but once I have an ottoman, I think I'm completely good to go. And this is my extension of my other closet. Since this is a lot bigger, it's a lot more, I don't know, it's more relaxed with the colors and stuff. So I would say number three again is organizing and like decorating your closet to something that you would like to go into every day to check out your wardrobe. And number four, I would say think about accessories, because that is a part of leveling up your attire. So I'll give you an example. This belt here is from All Saints. Now I'm gonna walk up a little bit so you guys can see the thickness of this belt. Do you see? This is a waist belt. But it's very pretty. It's very simple. Let me do this so you guys can see. It has the buckle. Very simple, right? But this is a waist belt that I would keep for a long time because the material is really, really good. And then also, so that's like a basic one, okay? Then I have some that are gold. This is from Zara, okay? Now I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I've never worn this belt, and I'll tell you why, because it's too small, okay? But I'm gonna get a wear out of this because it is super freaking heavy. And this is probably by far one of the best belts I've seen Zara have. And I absolutely love it. So I'm probably gonna take it. I'm gonna get creative with it because it's really tight. I'm gonna get creative with it, but I am going to get a wear out of it. At least one before I sell it or something. So that's that. Accessories, I would say, get you some great accessories to add to your wardrobe. Yes, all women should have the typical studs, that's fine. But when you wanna like really elevate it, you can get some statement jewelry. If you do not like statement jewelry, then please invest in great gold, great diamonds, and great white gold. Sterling silver is okay, but I prefer white gold to elevate the look a little bit more. And the last tip I would say is your shoes and your jackets, okay? When it comes to goal setting, and when I mean by shoes and jackets, I mean, I don't wanna just say designer, but I am gonna say designer for this example. At the end of the day, women, I'm gonna use this, you guys like those red bottoms, okay, but it's not for everyone. But if you feel that having a pair of Christian Louboutins is something that's going to add to your goal setting of your wardrobe, then buy it. Some people may like Brian Atwood. Some people may like Jimmy Choo. Some people may just like, what is her name? Tamara Mellon. Her boots are amazing, and I'm telling you guys, amazing. And I also think she actually co-founded Jimmy Choo. That's probably why her boots are really made really well. But if you want to add that in as your goal setting of your wardrobe, then by all means, do that. So those are a few tips that I think that you can start with starting to goal set for your wardrobe. And I think it's a good place to start. Start off slow. Do not spend all your money at one time. Invest in good pieces, guys. And just have fun with it. Your wardrobe is something that's going to last you for a long time. It's just not a closet full of clothes. Okay, guys? So if you like more videos like this, please comment below. And if you stay to the end of this video, please comment, Coco, we see you. And guys, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at CocoStylesNY. And don't forget, guys, I am starting, well, I'm relaunching my styling services, and I'm super excited because you guys are gonna have a great, great, great experience this time around, and I'm super ecstatic about it. So I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye.